Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, we're the Garceau twins and we have a very fun video for you today. Today we're going to be swatching and reviewing the Wet n Wild Liquid Catsuit High Shine Lipsticks. First, we're going to be doing the swatches of all 13 shades, and we'll leave the timestamp down below when that starts, and then we'll also leave the timestamp when the review starts, and that will be after the swatches. Claims of the product first, just so we can kind of suit our review to the claims. So I'm reading from the Ulta website, and it says that these high shine lipsticks combine all the comfort and shine of a gloss with the high pigment of a lipstick. It provides brilliant high shine and ultra pigmented lip lacquer to deliver a mirror-like gloss finish. This product is long wearing and has a creamy texture for easy application. Megalass Liquid Catsuit High Shine Lipsticks are infused with a blend of vitamins, plant base oils and butters, provides superior moisture and improve overall lip texture. They're fragrance-free, gluten-free, cruelty-free, paraben-free, and vegan. Okay, so we'll start with the pros of the formula. For me, a huge pro is that it's fragrance-free.
Me too.
Literally, you guys know we hate fragrance in all makeup and skincare. Mm-hmm. We don't know. It has no place there. And if it's like a natural fragrance, fine, but it's amazing that they didn't include fragrance in these. And also a lot of people put a masking fragrance in to mask the smell of the base. And while I respect that, because sometimes it can smell very not pleasant, I would just rather it be fragrance-free.
Yeah, and they just smell like nothing, which is great.
So I do think the claim that it's a high shine finish is true. I mean, as it dries down a little bit, it gets a little bit, I don't want to say tacky because it never gets tacky, but it's a little bit less glossy when you first put it on. But I feel like that's in a good way. It almost dries down to be a little bit thicker. So it feels like very emollient on the lips, but not sticky, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I think one of my favorite things about the formula is the feel on the lips. Like, it's not sticky at all. Like, it feels like a thin lip balm, in my opinion. So I think that's my favorite part about this, because you still get that pigment, but it feels so comfortable.
Yeah, exactly.
And we're not usually gloss people, but this is, again, so thin and comfortable that it feels so comfortable. So nice.
And it does, like, even though I'm not a gloss person, it makes your lips look so, like, nice.
It does.
It doesn't sink into the lines. It just gets a very, like, juicy look. And, yeah, I love the finish, definitely.
So to go into the cons of this one,
we have a few.
Mm-hmm.
So one con is definitely that all of these shades were pretty patchy. I don't think so. They claim to be highly pigmented, and I don't think that's true because, so I recently, even this week, I wore one of their matte catsuit liquid lipsticks, and those are so pigmented. I literally did my whole lips in one swipe, and I know that they're super matte and a lot of people don't like that, which is why they probably came out with this version, but I was hoping that the pigmentation on these would be equal to the matte version because of how pigmented they are. But these are just not very pigmented, so they just go on really patchy, and you really, really have to blend back and forth to get it to look even on your lips.
I would say another thing that is leading to that issue is the thinness of the formula. I think when you have a thicker formula, like Britta said, with the matte ones, it just goes on in one pigment. It's very easy to blend out and look really pretty and even. But with a thin formula, when the pigment is being like moved around, and then that's where the patchy crunchiness comes in, and that's what I think is happening.
Yeah, I agree.
It's like you put some down and then you try to move it around to make it look even, but then when you're moving it, it's like picking up on the pigment that's already been down. It just takes a very long time.
It takes a long time
to make it look even. These two shades that we're wearing, I'm wearing Cedar Later
and I'm wearing Sun Nudes.
Those are the two most even, I'd say,
yeah,
in our favorite colors. Mm-hmm. The rest were extremely patchy.
The dark ones, I mean, most dark shades in a range are going to be very patchy, but they were all so patchy.
Well, even the light ones, the ones that had a lot, yeah, of white base in them, are very patchy.
Yeah, which is surprising. The pinks were
not surprising because that
I guess that's makes, true. Yeah. The pinks were somewhere in the middle, and then these two were pretty good. Mm-hmm. That one being the best.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Is that everything for the formula?
I believe so.
Yeah.
And we don't like being negative, but we're just trying to be honest.
Yeah,
with
and I don't think it's that long wearing, but it does wear off.
Oh, exactly.
It does wear off very nicely. It mm-hmm. doesn't look, like, it doesn't, you know, like a matte liquid lipstick usually wears off terribly. You mm-hmm. just get, like, the outline, and then it wears off in the middle. These wear off super evenly, which is nice. So that is another pro, I would
yeah,
say.
Yeah, I wouldn't say they're long-lasting, but mm-hmm. that doesn't bother me. It's not something,
me too, yeah,
like, I need. So,
yeah.
And they're easy to reapply.
Yeah.
Okay, so now for the range. So there are 13 mm-hmm. total shades in here, which is a great range, I feel like, for a launch of a lip product. Mm-hmm. But there are, you guys know that we don't really like pinks, and a lot of people do. So there are a few pinks, which we understand, because mm-hmm. people like pinks. But then overall, I just feel like there are a lot of non-wearable shades. Like, there
yes.
are a lot of dark shades. The pinks that they do have, there are two. One was, like, a pinky nude, and one was, like, a cool tone pink. But the other few pinks are just, like, they're not a berry, which I would consider mm-hmm. wearable. They're just kind of, like, too bright and vivid.
Yeah, there's, like, a lot of neon tones,
yeah,
happening, I feel. And, yeah, I love bright shades, but you mm-hmm. have to do it correctly. Like, the tone has to be, like, complements, like, a variety of skin tones.
Yeah.
It can't be too pink or too purple, and I feel like these have a lot of, like, primary colors in them, if that
agreed.
Makes sense.
And I also think, but I do think nude wise, like this color and that, I would mm-hmm. both consider nude.
Oh yeah, beautiful shades.
Really beautiful and also very unique nude tones. Mm-hmm. I feel like they could have done like a true pinky nude and they didn't. Like they went with a more neutral, almost like peachy, and then that one is
it's like a mauve brown.
Yeah,
it's so
pretty. I feel like what they were trying to do was kind of just go with unique colors overall, and for the nudes it really worked in their favor because like I don't have a color mm-hmm. that looks like this or like that.
Yeah.
So it worked in that sense, but then in the other sense, it's like they have all these shades that a lot of people I don't think would gravitate
exactly.
towards. But I feel like that's fine because maybe there are some people out there that are like, oh, I love these like bright, bold colors. And if you like the formula, then why wouldn't you like buy mm-hmm. more than just these two shades?
Mm-hmm.
So just our preference is that we wish that there was a few more wearable shades.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so next is packaging. And we've talked about the Wet n Wild component multiple times. We love this component.
Yes.
It is just such a nice component. Mm-hmm. So nice. And they change out the applicator on these, I believe. I don't think
no,
this is...
No, I think it's the same.
The same?
Mm-hmm.
It's flexible like this?
Yeah, it's the same one.
Oh, well, we love the acrylic stem. I think that's
so
cute and pretty. And then this is so flexible. You probably can't see, but the doe foot...
I'm pretty sure this is the same as the matte
okay.
ones.
The doe foot has a lot of flexibility, which I really like, especially with this formula, like we were saying. You really need to work it in to make it not look patchy. The flexibility of the applicator really helps with that.
I feel like
I
if
love
it was
this
stiff,
wand.
It would be even worse.
Yeah, and I love this wand because I feel like when you first pull it out, it deposits like a pretty good amount of product.
Mm-hmm.
Specifically, again, going back to the matte version, like this would be enough to cover my
yeah.
whole lips. And then for these, you have to go in a few times. But I do like that you get a good amount of product. I feel like a normal doe foot, you don't get enough ever. And so you just
yeah,
have to keep dipping back in.
It has that little well.
Yeah, so mm-hmm. it holds the product there. So I love this packaging. I think it's
yeah.
like the best at the drugstore.
Yeah, it's really good. And it has that click, mm-hmm. like click cap.
Yeah.
Which is really cool.
So these are only $5.29 each on Ulta, which is a steal. Like, especially
mm-hmm.
for such nice packaging, I feel
that
like...
That is true.
Yeah, like, I think that there are some other alternatives that are around the same price point, but they don't look as nice. Which
yeah,
is,
like the Maybelline lipsticks we love, but the packaging
yeah.
is very cheap.
Yeah, yeah. So for the packaging, I love... And, I mean, the formula, we had some pros and some cons,
mm-hmm.
but overall, for a drugstore lipstick, I feel like that's a fantastic price.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so for our overall rating, we always do this 1 through 10.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
I'm going to go with a 6.
Yeah.
And I feel like we have this issue a lot where, like, when you look at the whole range, it kind of lowers the score because if we only gravitate towards some shades or only some shades in the formula work for us because the formula is inconsistent, then that kind of brings down the rating. Like this shade itself, like we said, wasn't patchy. I love this shade. The formula feels so nice. But then because the rest of the shades were patchy and I didn't like the colors, it just brings down the rating.
Yeah,
so that's
exactly
kind of where I'm getting the six from.
Yeah, there's a lot of like hits and misses here. Mm-hmm. Like again, the darker shades aren't very wearable and they're so patchy that that just brings down like our overall rating. And so we're trying to just give you like an overall picture of this whole range.
You would be a six as well.
A six as well. Mm-hmm. But I love these two shades. Yeah. I will continue to wear them. And I, again, like I like that they're, I love that Wet n Wild is like doing these types of things. Like I think that this high shine lipstick is a trend.
Yeah.
And like now that since they did this, like people that can't afford really high end brands can afford these. So
exactly.
I really admire them as a brand because they always like bring trends to the drugstore, which is awesome.
And they do generally do a good job.
We love
like
their
stuff.
We love these shades. So if you're watching this video and you're discouraged about the rest of the shades, just get these and I think you'd be happy.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
Thank you guys so much for watching this review and swatch video, and we hope you enjoyed it. Let us know if you've tried these down below.